In today's video, we're going to be talking about shared parameters. I consider them to be the first step towards full BIM because they offer a complete parameter customization. We're going to learn when they're necessary and how to create and use them. And we're going to cover this quickly before your boss figures out that you don't know Revit as good as you claimed on your resume. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. That's where I cover all of the interesting and complex topics in Revit in depth. There's over 140 hours of content, so make sure to check it out. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, but first let's cover what are shared parameters and how do we use them. Shared parameters are based on a shared text or .txt file, which can be hosted on your computer or better yet on a company server, so everybody in the company or everybody in the team can have access to them. So now first let's explore why are they important. Shared parameters increase the scope of what your parameters can affect and where can they be used. So let me explain on a practical example. So here we have an empty Revit project, and what I'll do is I'm just going to go here to file and then create a new family. For this family, I'm just going to be using the English metric generic model as kind of a basis, hit open. And then I'm just going to create a simple extrusion. And now when we open it up in a 3D view, this is basically what we have. So we have a simple cylinder. Now for this cylinder, I'll first go here to family category, and then I'm going to place it in the furniture category and click OK. Now I'm going to create a custom parameter for this family. So I'll go here to family types, and then I'm going to create a new parameter, and I'm just going to call this one the wrong parameter because I'm showing you how to do this the wrong way. And now let's make it a text parameter. We can leave it as a type parameter, click OK again, and now let's load this family into the project. But first I'll save it. Okay, so now once it's saved, let's load it into the project and place it here in the middle. So now once I have this cylinder or this furniture family here in the project, if I go to family types, what you'll notice is we have that wrong parameter here. I can give it a value, let's say 123, hit apply, okay. And now let's say we want to pull that value out of that family. So we can do this on multiple ways. One would be to add a tag family. So what I can do is I can go here to annotate, tag by category, and then just tag this element. And now what you'll notice here is that I really don't have the option in this tag family to show that wrong parameter. So even if I select the tag family and go into edit family, and then here, if I select the tag or a label text, go into a label, and if I search for that wrong parameter, I don't have it available here because it was created inside of that family, so its scope is only pretty much inside that family. The same thing would be if I were to go back to the project now, and let's say that for this family, I want to create a schedule to schedule that value, the wrong parameter value. Well, even if I go and create a schedule, so let's go here to view, schedules, and this is going to be a furniture schedule, so let's go to furniture. Okay, now I can perhaps add the family name, but if I search for that wrong parameter, it's nowhere to be found. So now when I create that schedule, it's just not going to have that parameter to report. That's because we used a wrong parameter. We have used a very localized parameter that only affects that particular family. Now let's create a shared parameter that's going to affect everything. It's going to affect the family, it's going to affect the tag, and it's also going to affect the whole project and all of the schedules inside of that project. So what they'll do now is go back to our floor plan here, and I'm actually going to create that shared parameter inside of the project. It doesn't really matter where you are when you're creating this shared parameter. So let's go to the Manage tab, and then let's go to our settings, and then here we have our shared parameters. Okay, so I'm just going to be creating a new one, so let's go here to create. I'm going to specify this location, and then this will be a test file.txt. hit save. And now we can create a new group. This will be furniture. Then you want to click OK. And then let's create a new parameter. And this is going to be the correct parameter. Okay, it will be the discipline is common, and then the data type will be text, as we have created with that wrong parameter. Now I can just click OK, and now we have that parameter. Click OK again. And now if I select this family, even though it's a furniture family, when I go to edit type, we don't really see that parameter. That's because we actually have to add it to all different elements separately. So now what I can do is I can select this family, go into edit type, it's going to open up that family, then I can go here into family types, and then I can add a new parameter, check shared parameters, select, and here we have that correct parameter. I'm just going to select that one, and as you can see, it's going to load everything in. Click OK, hit apply, OK, load that into the project, project one, click OK. And let's override this version. And now when I select it and go into edit type, we have that correct parameter, and let's give it an ABC value. Okay, hit apply and okay. And now it's time to go to the tag. So for the tag itself, again, let's go to edit family, select that label. Okay, go into edit. And now here, what we can do is we can search for that correct parameter, but it's not here. What you have to do is you have to go here to new, select a shared parameter, the correct parameter that we have created, click OK, OK again, and now it's there. Now we can just load it in, get rid of this one, OK, apply, OK, there we go, correct parameter, and now just load this back into the project and override the existing one. And now, as you can see, it's reporting that value. And finally, to show it in the schedule, so if I open up my furniture schedule, I can come here to our fields, and then here, because I have created that parameter inside of the project, it's going to appear here as the correct parameter. And now I can add that, and we are now reporting that value. So shared parameters really give you the ultimate flexibility of creating your own customized parameters inside of Revit. They can be whatever you want, and then you can connect them to different things. So you can connect them to your schedules, your tags, your families, your project, everything. And that's how shared parameters work. Now, if you want to get access to all of my Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. There you can find over 500 Revit files so far. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.